It's all about the money tonight. The dreaded R word is back. GDP dropped 0.1% in the December quarter. Following the fall in September, that means two in a row, and it's official, we're in recession. Doing well, however, the banks, who got a serve from the Commerce Commission as it investigates personal banking services. The Commission says the big four banks, who have 90% of the market, have focused on profit and not invested in technology or innovation. It's calling for disruptive forces to be introduced. Let's take a look. Last year, ANZ made a whopping $2.2 billion profit for the 12 months to September 2023. BNZ posted a record profit of $1.5 billion for the same period. And Westpac too, it raked in $963 million. While ASB made more than $1.5 billion for the year to June 2023. In a moment, we look at one option to increase competition, open banking. First, though, business correspondent Katie Bradford on where the disruption could come from and what it could mean for the way you bank.
So we have a maverick streak.
The self-styled maverick, KiwiBank, was set up as the locally owned market disruptor.
We're suggesting that the owner of KiwiBank really get behind that and turn it into a disruptive force.
To do that, it needs private investment or more cash from the government. 90% of the banking market is taken up by the big four. Then there's KiwiBank and a smattering of smaller players who struggle to get a foot in the door.
Are Kiwis being ripped off?
Well, look, I think there's an element of that. And clearly the ComCom has come to a view that we should be looking at some measures around competition.
It becomes the impetus of politicians to properly pay attention to this and to put in place evidence-based policy in order to reduce that feeling of customers being ripped off.
The four big banks make bigger profits here than overseas, and while they'll match each other's offers, they really beat them.
The banks have very high frequent information about what each other is doing in that market, and essentially what they do there, they will cut for somebody who's really negotiating, but that cut won't go across the rest of the market.
And that's not just at the expense of customers, but of technology and innovation too. In the 80s and 90s, we introduced EFTPOS and internet banking. We've now fallen behind on the innovation front, and customers are missing out.
This is using your mobile phone or maybe your internet experience, where you can move money around easier, you can free up funds, say for example out of your savings account, be used on everyday use without impacting your funds.
No bank would appear on camera today, all issued statements. ANZ strongly rejected claims profits were too high.
The Commerce Commission makes a really interesting point that the profits that banks are making are simply a reflection of the size of the businesses that they are. And then they then go on to say that actually regulation and requirements around regulations are what are providing a real hindrance.
Kiwis aren't getting a fair deal, and they should.
There are 16 recommendations for the Reserve Bank and government to consider, with a final report due in August.
So some pretty serious findings there, Katie. Can we realistically expect anything to change anytime soon, though?
Well, we've heard it again and again and again, haven't we, when it's been supermarkets, fuel companies, buildings, supplies. Kiwis are being ripped off. There's not enough competition. Well, now it's taken a 333-page report from the Commerce Commission to tell us the same thing about banks. We had quite a defensive statement from ANZ there today saying the profits aren't too big, that, you know, they're not making as much money as people think. So really the ball is going to be in the court of the government now about what they might do about that regulation to try and innovate a bit to bring us up to play with the rest of the world. But also around what we'll do with KiwiBank. National was very quick to say today that it will now go talk to its coalition partners about its options with regulation and with KiwiBank. When you look at those, though, if you were talking about getting some private investors in to help give KiwiBank more capital, partial privatisation is what you're talking there of the bank. You can imagine ACT might be a bit of a supporter of that. New Zealand First, always been a big proponent of a Kiwi-owned bank, unlikely to support that. The option then for the government is to really just look at pumping more capital, more money into KiwiBank. Whether it's willing to do that or not remains to be seen.
Kia ora, Katie. Thank you very much for that. As Katie's mentioned, the review wants open banking in place within 2 years. So what exactly is open banking and how will it help you? Laura Frickberg's been finding out.
Moving your money or mortgage from one bank to another, whatever the reason, should be simple, right?
The fact is, though, for many of us, it can seem just too difficult.
I haven't tried. I've been meaning to for ages, but I've just been like, I can't be bothered with the admin, to be honest.
With a bank that's kind of digital first, I found it easy, but the older banks maybe have been slower to adapt to that. It has been a bit of a ball ache.
But the Commerce Commission says it could all be so much easier through a system called open banking that allows you to control your personal financial data and for others who you choose to access it too, making it easier to open new accounts at different banks and to share it with third parties like apps to help manage your bills.
If you are able to move your money more freely, then they might actually try to do more to keep you.
It's not a new idea. Work on it began in 2017, but was described as too slow.
So in 2021, a new law was passed that allowed people to share data held about them with trusted third parties.
But the system is still lagging behind other countries, like the UK and Australia.
The banking sector's been on notice for years that this is a requirement. In fact, it's been mandated by government that they do this. It's frankly unbelievable that we haven't got open banking implemented in New Zealand yet.
It does have its critics, though. Some say it could make banking information more vulnerable to data breaches.
The wider that access is, the greater the risks that somebody can get in and have a breach. So there is definitely a higher risk, but at the same time, there's a lot of work that goes on to manage that.
While it's still early days for open banking here, the Commerce Commission wants it fully operational by 2026 to give us more say on our finances. Laura Frickberg, One News.